number 20. Asks us for
really, you guys are super impressing me right now. Yes. Silence, it's not. So negative 8/3 x plus 9. Okay. We've spent some time learning about graphs in general, what graphs are made of, which they're made of what?
Points.
Okay, well, I was checking in on that. Right. And the instructions, if you will, for finding those points, right there, that equation. Right? Or whatever equation we're given. We've been given simple equations, complex equations, and we've used them all to find points. Okay. This one we're going to use to find points and to kind of prep you for what we're going to continue to do today. How about instead of me just throwing numbers at you as I've done the last few days? So as we try to find points, let's try and be clever about it and find points that are easy to find. Let's find an easy point. Somebody throw at, by that I mean throw at an x value that we're going to use. Kate?
Zero.
Okay, so we'll start a little table here. X and y. Put a zero there. Let's do all the work for it right here. 8/3 times zero plus nine. What do we get?
Nine,
right? We don't really write zero plus nine. We know zero plus nine is going to be nine. So 0, 9. And my oh my, was that easy, right? Very simple. Okay. Let's also put our phones away or we're going to lose them to phone jail. Okay. Robert?
Three.
Three. You're going to plug in a three. Now, Robert, why did you plug in one or two? Why did you choose three?
Because it's just easier. You can, like, cross the divide and then you just, like,
3
times 1
and
5
divided. Yeah, we're using that. You know, we were saying cross divide today, not cross multiply. We already have cross divide. When we get 8/3 times 3 over 1, if you like. Okay. Now the 3 is going to divide the 3. What's 3 divided by 3?
1.
One or zero?
One.
Divided by three.
Yeah.
So we get one here, you get one here. Denominator's one, so really no denominator, because we don't need to write denominators of one anyway. Okay? -8 times one. -8 plus nine is one. So 3 and 1. Okay. Let's do one more. One more that's gonna fit on this graph, of course, not the way up high, but stay inside this graphing area. Zach?
-3.
-3. Well, let's take a look. -8/3 times -3/1. We get the cross canceling, cross dividing, right? 3 divides -3. What's -3 divided by 3?
-1.
-1. Okay, we're gonna add 9. Now what's -8 times -1?
+8.
It's 8. So we get 8 plus 9.
17.
Is that gonna fit here?
No.
It's gonna be way up here, alright? If we had graph paper that went that high, we certainly would graph that point. But that's what I was talking about. We want another point that's gonna actually fit. Brandon?
1.
Plug a 1 in there. Okay, but that's gonna make our calculations, you know, more work than they have to be. Emma says 6. What do you guys think about 6?
Yeah.
6. Okay, -8/3 times 6. Why is 6 a good idea? Emma?
Because you go from 0 to 3 and then you go 3 more up, which is 6. So you'll get like an easier
one. Okay, so you're just following the pattern 0 to 3 was a good idea. How about I go another 3 to 6? In the calculations, we see that we can take 6 and divide it by 3, which leaves us with 2. -8 times 2 is -16.
-7.
So go over to 6, down to -7. 7. All right, I think if we went, well, what if we went over another 3? How far would we go down from there? Go down 4 more?
No.
Oh, go down how much? If we went over from this point, if we moved over 3, how far down would we go from there? Let's look at what we've done so far. If I start at this point and I go over 3, how far do I have to go down to get to the next point? Down how much? From 9 down to 1, I went down 8. If I move over 3 again, how much do I move down?
8.
If I move over 3 again, how much will I move down?
8.
8 again. Okay.
You can find that right there.
You can find that right there, exactly. That's what we're trying to solidify. Did you get back?
What? Oh, no.
Okay, so yeah, we can see that here as we graph more and more of these. We'll see like, oh, that over 3 and down 8 thing, I could have told that was going to happen right there, because every number that I plug in for x, I would like to be divided by that 3. And on it goes, we follow that pattern, we start to see it on the graph, and we start to see that, well, here's kind of a funny question. If I move over 3, I move down 8. What if I only move over 1?
Down
how much?
8.
Down 3, down 8. Over 1, down 8. So there'll be a point right there?
Yeah.
No.
Over 1, down 4.
Down 4. Over 1, down 4. That put me there. What do you guys think about that one?
3.
No.
It's actually going to be not a whole number.
Over 1, down 3 and a half.
3 and a half?
3,
no.
1 and a half.
Actually, I'm going to move over 1. I would move down
2 and
eight
a half.
Thirds. Down 8 thirds. Okay? If I moved over 1, I'd move down 8 thirds. Here's 3 thirds, 6 thirds, 7, 8 thirds. Right? It's not right on the grid. It's not right on one of these little dots here. It's not a nice point to graph. It's possible. If I moved over another 1, I'd move down another 8 thirds. So 1 third, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 thirds. Right there. Over another one, I moved down another 8 thirds. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What do you know? There I am down there at that point. That's
yeah.
The point here is the ratio of your horizontal to your vertical change is always the same. It's always 8 to 3. 8 to 3. The ratio of horizontal to vertical is 8 to 3. Yes, no. The ratio of vertical to horizontal is 8 to 3. So if I move over some, I need to move down an amount that's 8 thirds of that amount. Okay. And we get a bunch of points. But if we had all of eternity to graph, eventually all those points would look like what?
A line.
A line. So we cheat, and we draw that line. That would start to take shape if we had all of eternity, but we don't. So we don't cheat because we're bad, we cheat because we're mortal and we don't have enough time to plot all these points. One more question that they ask about this is, what's the x-intercept?
Oh no.
Negative
slope. Okay, well let's talk about the word intercept. What does intercept mean?
Like
cross. Okay. Intercept basically means cross. So what would it mean to cross something about x?
When the line crosses the x.
The x what?
The x-axis.
The x-axis, right. So where it crosses the x-axis, this thing right here, which you can see by the graph, is not a nice whole number. So we got to find it somehow.
Like
4
thirds.
Well, it looks like 1, 2, 3. And something. 3 thirds would be 1. 3 and 1
3 and
would be something else. Yeah, maybe you're right about that. Let's find out for sure, though. Here's how we can find out for sure. This is the point I'm looking for. Robert's trying to guess what the x value is, right? And 3 and a third is a good enough, I mean, it's a fair guess. It's probably close to 3 and a third, whatever it is, if not exactly 3 and a third. And the point is, we do not know for sure just by looking at the graph. But do you know the other part of this point?
Zero.
It's zero because it's on the x-axis. Anything on the x-axis is not up here. It's not down here. It's right in the middle at zero. So that zero for y, well, I can use the equation and say, well, I know that for this point, y is going to be zero. So I need to solve this equation and figure out, right, what to plug in for x so that the answer will be zero. So we'll just subtract 9 from both sides. You get -9 equals -8/3 x. How do we cancel out this -8/3 that's being multiplied by x?
Multiply it by positive.
Multiply
by
the reciprocal.
The reciprocal. Right, you want to cancel out this -8/3 that's being multiplied by x. What I'd like to see in front of x being multiplied by x is a 1, right? The way to turn a fraction into a 1 is to multiply it by its own reciprocal, -3/8. And so I get 24/24. That's 1. On the other side, I have to do the same thing, of course. You're going to multiply by -3/8. Now, 8 and 9 don't share any factors, right? So there's no cross dividing that's going to happen. So we're just going to get -3 times -9 is 27. 8 times 1 is 8. 27 eighths. We could write it as a mixed number if we like. That would be 3 and 3/8. 3 and 3/8. So that's not too far off of 1/3. Real close to 1/3. Okay, so there's your x-intercept right there. I know the x-intercept y is going to be 0. Tell y to be 0. Figure out what x would give you that 0. There you have it. That's what it is. So now we know that this is 3/8. Now I'm going to another one. 24 is what I said. Apples. Okay, so you go to a harvest festival and pick apples, which equation represents the cost in dollars of going to the festival. If you look in the picture, it says that admission. What does admission mean?
How much to get in?
Three S's in admission.
There are?
No. So it costs $5 just to get in, just to get in the door or through the probably a fence because this is apple picking, it's not indoors.
It could be.
Could be. They had some hydroponics going on.
Does it just have a giant greenhouse?
5 cents. Yeah. 75 cents. Per pound. I don't know what HP stands for. LB stands for pound. Okay. 75 cents per pound. Let's put a dollar sign there. So we got two choices. We got the choice of y equals 5x plus 0.75. Where x would represent the number of pounds that you pick. Or is it y equals 0.75x plus 5? What do you guys think? Which equation, if you plugged into one of these equations the number of pounds that you picked, which equation would tell you how much the whole ordeal costs, Emma?
The second one.
The second one. Explain why.
Because the pounds of x, and then you add 5 because that's how much you got. It costs to get in.
Okay.
You don't add
$5 every time you buy a pound, but you do add.
But you add it after.
What do you add every time you buy it? You pick a pound.
75 cents.
So 75 cents once, twice, three times, four times, five times, right? Depending on the number of pounds. Not $5. $5 is not $5 every time you pick a pound. Just like Emma said. Why am I saying that Emma said twice? Okay. So it's this one. Not this one. Okay, so we could graph this by saying I know 0 pounds is going to cost me how much?
Zero. $5.
Overall, $5, right? Because we got to pay $5 to get in there, $0 to buy that 0 pounds. So we start at $5, so we call our y-intercept. Well, I could go over 1 pound, right? And that goes up by how many dollars?
5. 75 cents.
75 cents. 0.75 over dollars. 75 cents goes here. could plug 1 pound, sorry, into this equation and get 0.75 times 1 plus 5, y equals 5.75. Okay, so there we are, 1.75. But you know what? If I put together enough 75 senses, doesn't it go to like a whole number amount?
Yeah.
How many pounds would I have to buy to get so that I could just give them like no quarters, just straight dollar bills?
4.
4 pounds? How much? If I buy 4 pounds, how many dollars would that be? Just, you know, a nice even amount of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
5 pounds?
$5.
$5. Sorry. 4 pounds cost $5.
Yeah.
No,
it's
4 pounds.
$3.
Yeah.
$3?
No.
Actually, it
costs
$8.
Okay.
Yes.
Just talking about the per pound part, and then we'll add the 5, right? So you say 3 as well. 3 plus the 5?
3.
I said
3. 3?
Yeah.
Now we're all on board with $3?
Yes.
Plus the $5?
Yes.
Yeah, so if we buy 4 pounds, so if we buy in groups of 4 pounds instead of 1 pound, then we don't need to carry quarters with us in there. You know what I'm saying? We don't have to pay in parts of dollars. We can pay in entire dollars, right? We buy 4 pounds because it's got 75 cents. Another 75 is $1.50. Well, I know $2.50s are $3, right? So I'll buy 2 more pounds. Another $1.50 is $3.
$8 for 4 pounds.
Let's move over four pounds and pay $3 more for a total of $8, which is perfectly in line with that of buying 1 pound and adding on 75 cents because the ratio of vertical to horizontal change is exactly the same. One way we could also see this is to write 0.75 in fraction form. What is 0.75 as a fraction?
3/4.
3/4 x plus 5. Well, look at that. Now we see, just like we did in the previous one, that this guy is 4, and I would like to go in lots of 4 pounds so that when I plug in something that's 4 or 8 or 16 or what have you, it can get divided by 4. Okay. So that's a weird one as well. But either way, we have our line. I do like to plot those points right on the grid lines because that's just a lot easier. Going the other direction, I'll go back 4 pounds and down $3. So I get a nice straight line.
Yeah.
Now we're going to practice some more. Here's the deal.